Hi friends, let's study article 14 of URR 725, disclaimer on transmission of messages. A reimbursing bank assumes no liability or responsibility for the consequences arising out of delay, loss in transit, mutilation or other errors arising in transmission of any messages, delivery of letters or documents when such messages, letters or documents are transmitted or sent according to the requirements stated in the credit. Now, credit, reimbursement authorization or reimbursement claim. Now, this is half part of the sentence and remaining half part is separate. We'll study this half part first. I think if there is any competition of Guinness World Record for the longest sentence, I think this would be one of them. So, let's study this half part first. Firstly, remember one thing, the gist of all the whole sentence is the reimbursing bank is not responsible for any loss or transit or mutilation of any messages. When it transmits any message, it is not responsible for any loss or anything mutilation. Now, there are a few points to ponder upon. What is loss in transit? Means if I am transferring through teletransmission, then how can the data be lost? This is regarding the letters. Suppose if I don't transmit it to teletransmission, but I do it through physical letters, then this can happen. Mutilation. How can mutilation happen? Mutilation in English means degrading the face or the appearance. Means if the A appears to be written as G or something like that, which we cannot read. So, the reimbursing bank is not responsible for such thing. If, how can this happen? In physical letters, if water falls on some letter, on some page, and it is not visible, then that is mutilation. In teletransmission, if the teletransmission ink is not proper, the printer ink is not proper, then the words won't appear in a readable form. So that is mutilation. So reimbursing bank is not responsible for all these errors if. For more videos, you can follow our paid version. For paid version, you can WhatsApp us on this number. The videos are shared with you on Drive, and then once you have downloaded, then you can watch them without internet. You can keep them for lifetime. See here, these videos of CDCS are not only important for your exams, but throughout your career in trade finance, these videos would be useful to you. You can also download YuvaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, test, question banks with explanations, job openings directly on your mobiles. You can follow us on Facebook on this link. Now, how many videos are there? See here, ISBP, it's 76 videos. In fact, daily or monthly new updations are done. UCP, 57 videos. General videos means other than all these UCP, ISP, ISBP, URR and EUCP, 55 videos. Then EUCB 12 videos, URR 27 videos, ISP 67 videos. Now remember one thing, all these videos cover the latest versions of all these 5 things. Basically 5 books. To be more precise, ISBP 745, UCB 600, EUCB 1.1, URR 725 and ISP 98. As and when the editions are changed, the videos are changed accordingly. So you need not worry about that. Also, there are 500 plus questions with explanations and correct answers. So your explanations are very important so that you understand why the answer is whatever it is given. It also includes doc check case studies similar to that of in-basket and standalone and simulation exercises. Plus, real-time solutions are given on WhatsApp also. You have practice tests available on the app, so you can try that also. First thing you need to do is WhatsApp on this number to get the paid version, because on this app you will be needing internet, and if you take the paid version you don't need any internet. So keep studying, keep watching.